Так, ну що,
Майже
майже
ми
ми
всі
всі зібралися.
зібралися. Доброго
Доброго
ранку
ранку
всім
всім
ще
ще
раз.
раз.
Пропоную, так,
Доброго
пропоную
ранку.
одразу. Добрий ранок. Пропоную одразу розпочати наш суперфінал. Всі суперфіналісти у нас присутні. Нагадую, регламент 5 хвилин на виступ, 5-7 хвилин на запитання. Презентації, доповідь англійською мовою. І бажаю всім удачі. Розпочинаємо з Думайла Володимира. Володимир, ви тут? Чуєте нас?
Так.
Все. Дякую, розпочинайте.
Hi, my name is Volodya. I'm 16 years old. Next slide, please. The ecosystem of the planet Earth has never been static, but the changes were relatively slow. We all know that all paleontological revolution actually lasts millions of years. However, since a man began mastering the environment in his own interest, everything has changed dramatically. I want to pay your attention to the image on the right. This is a painting by artist Elarion Krashnikov, which show how our ancestors cut down and burned the forest to turn in into flax groves. It is obvious that the cycle of all substance, especially water, which has been established for epoch, will change dramatically in a year. But now we are talking about situation a century ago. Nowadays, situation is more dynamic and larger. Let's pay attention to the cutting of Brazilian sand. Next slide, please. By developing new territories or even planting new plants in old lands, especially with intensive use of fertilizer, we can start completely unpredictable environment process. Therefore, in agronomy, the issue of constant monitoring of acidity is becoming more acute, and the industry produce a lot of devices to for measuring soil acidity, but they all have number of disadvantages, the main of which is need for an operator who will maintain and use this device all the time. Next slide, please. Therefore, the task of this project is to develop a fully automatic and autonomous complex, which will require only occasion maintenance. By plants placing such complex in the field, the agronomist would always know in real time the situation with the soil pH level without need to go through all the fields personally. Next slide, please. As a stationary matter, it has been decided to use pH matter as QSN 0161, which is system is nested flux filled with detrited reagents. The outer flux has porous wall holding the reagent inside. Nevertheless, it allows to react a concentration of hydrogen ions outside the flux. Such sensor is more complex than biometallic electrodes. Next slide, please. Taking a measure of soil acidity pH matter has been tested experimental and proved to be the best. The fabrics that protect it from mechanic damage add some inertia to the measurement speed. In our case, it was 20-30 minutes, but it isn't problem because the control program has been adjusted. Next slide, please. After successful inspection of the system as pH controller, it has been decided to give it the function of full control of the irrigation process. The logic of the irrigation process can be seen in the picture. First, we wash and calibrate the pH matter. Next, waiting for some time, we measure moisture and acidity of the soil. According to the soil moisture, we determine that we needed the needed amount of irrigation water, fill the mixer tank with required amount of it. Then the watering pump is switched on and all the water enters the field. Next slide, please. The irrigation system has been designed and successfully tested. And moreover, it can already be called intelligent because after watering the several hours monitors of soil acidity and moisture, according to which adjustment can be made between the soil moisture and amount of irrigation water to the dependence between pH and amount of tetrated solution added to its correction. And next slide, please. By providing the connection between irrigation and actual condition of the soil, the control system will be able to make more efficient to use both water and alkalinity and acidity correctors. The proposed irrigation and control system will create facilities to work of the agronomist by taking routine duties. And if necessary, the irrigation and management system can take full control of soil irrigation. Next slide, please. Thanks for watching.
So, dear jury, do you have any questions to our Volodymyr first finalist?
Yes, I will start, okay?
Okay.
Show please the presentation.
What?
I need the presentation in order to do the questions. For example, slide number 4. Tell me please, you show this picture as principle of your work, principal technology of your work. Where is it possibility to add acids or hydroxide ions?
Yes, it's only one. It's only with pH matter. In next slide, we can see that all system with all tanks with acidity and water. What in this slide we can see?
Here we can see. And what for do you use this distillated water?
What? Can you repeat, please?
Let me see. For what reason do you propose to use the distillated water?
To calibrate the pH meter.
Calibrate the pH meter. But it's impossible to calibrate pH meter only with help of distillated water. You need
And also it can function to clean from the soil as the pH.
Oh, this is the right. This is the right answer. Okay. Slide number 8. Slide number 8. Next one. On this slide you show the method of correct pH of soil by for one vegetable, for one plant. Yeah.
Yes.
And I cannot. See on the, it's not very good picture by other words. If you did all these works, it would be better to, maybe it would be better to make more informative pictures, because on this picture, I'm not sure that I can understand something.
Oh, okay.
Some glasses without any, information, what we can use from this, what we can take from these glasses.
It is a picture of my device. In this box with green, this green box, we can see, or we don't can see, but there are all devices, yes.
No, okay, thank you. Thank you. Julia.
Okay, any other questions?
May I ask a question?
Yes, of course.
Can I see this slide number 7? Okay, Vladimir, do you take into account the physical chemical properties of inner water before mixing? Because the water is different anywhere, and I think it can influence the water properties, can influence on the result of mixing with acids or alkalines. What do you think about that?
I think we can take the filtered water and it can mix without any problems.
Okay, filters is good, but what do you mean about filtration of the water? It will be water from the wells or underground water or river water. It's very different to make it good.
I think we can take the must clean it clean it water.
Okay, thank you. You understand this question and it's
yes.
Very nice. And thank you for good English.
So thank you, Vladimir. If you have any other questions,
yes, I have a small question.
Oh, okay. Please.
Thank you for a good presentation, Vladimir. Your English very nice with good pronunciation. It's very important for our project. My question is final, and as my colleague yesterday mentioned, in what advantage of your approach, your methods, comparing with different approaches and methodology to check the quality of the soil, especially in this component, if you propose to check for according irrigation and using water for irrigation. Thank you.
Yes, there are a lot of devices for measuring soil acidity, but like mine isn't exist yet. And the mine proposed was to create a device that can properly care for plants. I saw that it can be exotic plants, but it can also use for all field for whole field and other plants
It's not so clear for me. It's a very important question, really very important. And you have to understand by yourself and to tell for us what are the what is the difference between your job, your proposition, and in comparison with today using the same methods.
Yes, my device is have a lot of advantages because we don't need the operator, but in other devices they have all number of disadvantages. The main of them is a need for an operator who will maintain and use this device all the time.
Okay, thank you.
So, thank you, Vladimir. It was a great start of today. And we will continue with your favorite Daria. Daria, please start.
Good afternoon, dear jury. My name is Yerefeva Daria, and I want to present to you my work on the topic assessment of the toxicity of lake water in Borispil using the GROWS test. Please, next slide. The relevance of my work is undeniable because in the process of human recreational activities, there is a significant anthropogenic impact on the environment. The result of such influence is the gradual degradation of natural complexes through the direct impact of man on nature. The aim of my work was to assess the toxicity of lake water samples of the studied areas and to establish the relationship between anthropogenic load and natural water quality of the lakes of Borispil. Next slide, please. For the study, I selected 5 sites and drinking water from the private company Zhiva Voda. For control tap, I took water which is supplied by Borispil Water Canal. Please, next slide. Research methods you can see on slide. Please, next slide. With help of my parents, I float into the middle of each lake and collected lake water in bottles with 500 milliliters capacity. The samples were delivered to the laboratory and poured into laboratory beakers with a capacity of 150 milliliters. Please, next slide. It was necessary to take 3 glasses of water for each water sample. Then, with the help of my supervisor, I made special floating discs and laid out 20 panyanka wheat seeds on them, covered them with transparent lids, and left them for 2 days. Then, the lids were removed, and the wheat was left to germinate for another 14 days. When the seeds germinated, I took them out and took some measurements. I measured the length of roots. Also, I measured stems and weighed the raw and dry mass. Please, next slide. All results were processed using the following formulas: finding the arithmetic mean and the error of its measurements, variance of sampling, and student's criterion. According to the table, I made the following conclusions. If we take into consideration different samples of lake water, we can see that the biometric indicators of the indicator plant have different effects on the 3 main processes of wheat seedling formation. They are seed germination, seedling growth, and coordination of the growth of its origins. This indicates the different quality of these water options and accordingly the different level of their toxic effects on the body. Growth processes of plants germinated in the studied water of samples number 2, number 5, and number 6 do not differ significantly from the control, which indicates the absence of toxic properties. Please, next slide. Analyzing the diagram, I made these conclusions. The phytotoxic effect, which determined the sanitary condition of water in model areas from the 1st to the 6th, was from 62.3 to 17%. In the area with the strongest anthropogenic influences, it is sample number 1. The indicator is the largest. At the same time, sample number 5 has the lowest value. The index of phytotoxic effects statistically significantly indicates differences in water quality of the studied water bodies from the 1st to the 5th. Please, next slide. As a result, I came to the following conclusions. The growth processes of plants germinated on samples of the studied water from different lakes of Borispil differ significantly. Given the data of bioindication, it can be argued that the water area of Nestor Lake and its adjacent coastal territory form an area with a critical level of pollution that is dangerous for their inhabitants. The territory and water area of Alexandrovsky and Lesnitsky lakes, on the contrary, can be used as a recreational and safe recreation area for residents and guests of the town. Please, next slide. The index of phytotoxic effect statistically significantly indicates differences in water quality of the studied water. Thus, the use of wheat is as a bioindicator organism make it possible to obtain a reliable integrated characteristic of the sanitary condition of lake water and to determine the ecological status of reservoir by their level of anthropogenic load. Please, next slide. The work has a great practical importance because the results of the project can be included in a special program strategy for sustainable development of Borispil 2025. Following the example of Borispil, other cities can also conclude their own sustainable development strategies. As the method of diagnosing the toxicity of lake water using a growth test is low cost, also it is relatively fast and easy to perform, so anyone can assess the condition of any reservoir. This research method, as a part of a large study, can be included in a comprehensive assessment of water quality. Thank you for your attention and waiting for your questions.
Thank you, Daria. It was very good English with high speed. So wait for questions.
And very clear.
Yes, it was really nice.
Can I ask?
Yes.
Daria, tell me please, you show on slide, I don't remember which one, about Java Vada, where is it?
The short one.
Yes. Tell me, please, why did you choose this Java Vada as a compared example? And what is it, Java Vada? It's drinking water.
Java Vada, it is private company which makes from the usual water from Borispil Vodokanal drinking water. They produce this water and
sell it to people.
So I choose this water because I use it in my usual life. I drink it every day, so I thought that it will be interesting to understand safe if this water is safe.
Safe for what? You compared the recreated lakes, yes?
Yes,
water for recreation purposes, and you compare the requirements, the sanitary norms for water for recreation purposes, absolutely different than for drinking water. And to compare this, I am absolutely sure that this reverse osmosis, demineralized water with this recreation water, I am not sure that this is right and this is correct.
But for control, to compare this control, we took water from Borispil Vodokanal and I thought that it will be correct to compare it is with water which is used by people in our town, because people wash their hands with water from Borispil Vodokanal and, for example, swim in lakes of our town. So I thought that compare results of my finding, I thought that it will be correct.
I'm not sure. Thank you very much for your answer, but it's a really interesting question. Okay. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Daria. We have a question from Agrofishina Irina. In your work, you carefully describe the assessment of nature of water pollution. I like the approach to bioeducation. What is the real practical application of this approach apart from public awareness?
Okay, what about the practical importance? I said some words in my work. I think that it is very important for our town because we showed our results to our government, our town government, and they said that they will make some more studying about our lake water, because they saw results of our work and said that it is so bad. Also, I think that this method can be used by every person, because it is very useful, and also it is not expensive way to understand if water has some toxic characteristics.
Sorry, can I make one more question? Yes?
Yes.
Daria, tell me please, is it the absolutely new method or somebody used it before you?
No, it is not my own method. This method is used in some universities also for studying children, but it is new. But in our town, nobody used this method to understand the toxicity of lake water. So in our town, it is a new way to understand the quality of water.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Daria. Do we have any other questions?
Is it possible to make new question? Or we have no time?
Yes. Yes, we have time.
Please. Show me, please, the slide number 10. A nice picture. Oh, thank you. Daria, I am not a great expert in the fields of biotesting. That is why I'm great sorry for incorrect question. But when I looking in control sample and looking on the samples from the different lakes, I see that the samples from different lakes is much more healthy, wealthy, strong and young. That is why my question is, do you take into account the influence of fertilizers, for example, phosphates or nitrates, on the results of your experiment?
Yes, but to tell the truth, this photo is not correct because I didn't show the all plants from control, and now I can show you that they are not different from other lake samples. I have them at home. Now, here is control, and here is number 5, for example. 1 second, please. Here they are. And
yes,
you can
I see. Oh, it's another picture. So I can recommend you to change the picture in your presentation because control must be better in the basis of clean water than from the different lakes. Thank you, Daria, for your English and for your good presentation.
Thank you.
So thank you, Daria. And we will continue with Kuleshova Sofia. Sofia, please start.
Good afternoon, jury members and the audience. My name is Sofia Kuleshova, and today I'm representing you my research work, which is called Composite Adsorbent Based on Calcium Alginate for Purifying Sewage. Now, next slide, please. Nowadays, water bodies of Ukraine are suffering from pollution. Industries which are situated on the river banks pollute them, pouring down partly cleared wastewater. I've done a lot of effective and intensive work to solve the problem of water pollution caused by micro concentrations of heavy metals. Next slide, please. Water treatment includes many different methods of purification, one of which is adsorption. It's used at a concentration of pollutants less than 1 gram per cubic decimeter. Next slide, please. While doing the research, I have carried out 25 experiments, repeating each of them for 5 times, created and investigated 6 adsorbents, both independently and in the composition with hydrogel balls, in order to remove the largest number of heavy metal ions from purified sewage, that is, for effective use with their low concentration. Next slide, please. According to the results of physicochemical tests of water samples, I received following results. As for the level of pH, sample number 1 refers to the slightly alkaline waters, number 2 to neutral waters, number 3 to slightly alkaline waters, but the alkalinity is higher than in the first one. As for the degree of aggression to materials and constructions, all the samples relate to a non-aggressive or practically neutral waters. In terms of oxidation reducing potential, the water samples relate to oxidizing geochemical states. The purpose of the first stage of my work was to carry out a number of experiments during which I investigated the absorption properties of such sorbents as calcium alginate, diatom clay, and activated carbon. According to the result of this stage of the experiment, the effectiveness of the use of these sorbents was too low. Next slide, please. After analyzing literature, I learned that calcium alginate is widely used in food industry and cosmetology as a thickener, gel former, and a encapsulation substance. In medicine, it's used as the basis of medicines to withdraw heavy metals from human body. So that's why calcium alginate was chosen as a basis for the creation of my composite absorbent. The second stage was aimed at creating a composite absorbent based on calcium alginate. At the third stage of the work, I carried out 10 experiments on the studying of absorption properties and processes by the composite absorbents. Next slide, please. At the fourth stage of laboratory studies, I analyzed the concentrations of heavy metals in sample number 3 before and after the absorption process using composite absorbent based on calcium alginate and diatomite. This adsorbent revealed the best absorption properties. Next slide, please. Investigation of the content of heavy metals in water samples was carried out in production and research laboratory of NovaCore plant using atomic emission spectral analysis with inductive blinding plasma. The obtained results indicate that the composite adsorbent based on calcium alginate and alginate and diatom clay effectively purifies water and reduces low concentrations of heavy metal ions, which we do not usually pay attention to and do not refine water from them. The hazardous substances accumulate and carry enormous harm to the environment and human health. Next slide, please. My absorbent purifies the water effectively and decreases concentrations of such ions as cadmium 2 plus and zincon 2 plus, which are related to the first hazard category, wolfram 2 plus that belongs to the second hazard category, and manganese 2 plus, which belongs to the third hazard category of heavy metals. The degree of purification confirms high efficiency of my composite absorbent. The degree of purification, for example, of ions of wolfram 2 plus charge amounted 79.1%, manganese 2 plus 78.5%, and it's just a wonderful result. Next slide, please. Judging from the results, I believe that my composite absorbent based on calcium alginate and diatom clay is forward looking for the treatment of sewage poured by metallurgical factories from ions of heavy metals. Next slide, please. Besides, the use of my composite absorbent will help economically solve such environmental problems as the treatment of sewage from the ions of heavy metals and the improvement of the non-waste industrial cycle. Thanks for your attention.
Thank you, Sofia. So, please, questions?
May I ask you?
Yes.
Dear Sophie, good presentation, thank you. And my question is, do you know what your weakness of your research is? Because it's very important for your future in Stockholm, understanding in weakness and question, future question. From authority and from for decided who will be a winner in this conference. Thank you.
Thanks for your question. I believe that the weakness of my work consists in the fact that my hydrogel balls can be not very important or not very comfortable to use in some of industrial factories, because of course we can use it both in static and dynamic conditions, but it will be more important for these balls to use them in static conditions, but at modern industries it's not very good method. They have different conditions to
Equipment.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Equipment which needs even dynamic conditions.
Okay. Can I ask?
Yes.
Tell me, please, Sophia, how did you obtain this granulated sorbent alginate of calcium? You bought it or you did it?
Thanks for your question. We did alginate calcium. We bought alginate natrium, sodium alginate, and calcium chloride, and made a ratio proportion, and using a drip method, we obtain these balls.
But what way did you obtain granulated these particles of sorbent? I understand that you mixture these components. It was the reaction between them. You obtained the gel. Yes.
Yes.
And then
I dripped it in the solution of calcium chloride, and they become
this granulated form.
Yes, yes.
Automatically, without.
Yes, automatically.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Oh, and then what did you do? Did you dry it or you filtered it from the?
We just put it out from the solution of calcium chloride and let them dry.
And then use. And it was enough for, for this. And the second one question is, why did you propose the mixture of different sorbents? I don't remember the name of second one. Not only.
Thanks for your question. I choose exactly composite adsorbent to maximize the effect of it.
You showed that the mixture of sorbents is better than.
Yes.
And did you have you any ideas why the mixture is better than single one?
We are sure that the composition is much better than a single one due to the fact it has more per centimeters, which it how to say it. Yeah, it has much more square centimeters to withdraw ions of heavy metals.
Okay, thank you.
So we have question one more from Andrew Fishnerina. In your opinion, is it safe to use calcium alginate that is extracted from seaweed, the latter unknown to able to accumulate a significant amount of heavy metals?
Thanks for your question. We're sure that using alginate calcium and alginate sodium alginate is okay, and it is not harmful for water and human health.
Okay, why you're sure?
Because it's used in food industry, in cosmetology, in medicine, and it's...
Thank you.
Thank you, too.
So, thank you, Sophia. Any questions?
Can I ask Sophia?
Yes.
Sophia, why do you start from the industrial wastewater and not... home drinking water? You all live in town Dnipro, where this question is very urgent, as they know. And if you will speak and discuss about drinking home water, drinking water purification system, you eliminate a lot of different questions. because your sorbents will be in a great competition with exchange resins, for example, and different sorbents, which are using now in industries. That is why I think it will be not better, but maybe you will think about home water purification.
Thanks for your question and recommendation. We will take it, but we decided to start exactly from wastewaters because it's very relevant for our region, because we have lots of different industries which are situated on the bank of the Dnipro River, and the question of polluting water is very is on the top. Why is it better? Because the cost is much it costs much less than ion exchange different. Yes, thank you.
Okay, so you have a lot of forces to struggle against competition, yeah. Competitors. So thank you very much.
Thank you
for your answer and good English.
Thank you, Sofia. And we will continue with Lubanet Dalia. Dalia, please.
Yes, I'm there.
Okay.
You should begin. Good afternoon. My name is Lubanet Dalia, and I present the research book "Research on the Possibility of Using Fungicide Steramarina as an Alternative Raw Material for the cellulose paper industry." Next slide, please. The aim of the work is to find alternative sources of raw materials for the pulp and paper industry. Unfortunately, in the world we live, passing year decreases the number of woods and raw materials for making paper. Also, increasing environmental requirements. So, the goal is to find sources to replace wood and paper in material. The main synthesis for the production of valuable paper is the cellulose, which is a natural polymer and the main components of the shell of plant cell. Its mechanical strength combined with its elasticity makes cellulose the best option for producing a variety of packaging paper, which can be used to make stitches and handkerchiefs. Next slide. Production of forests affects the environmental condition of the planet. Therefore, the search for alternative raw materials for paper industry is relevant. And this will reduce ecological pressure and save the forests. Using organic steramarina as a raw material for the production of paper contributes to a shorter direction of the technological process, reducing wasteful discharging of paper production and expanding the syrup base at the expense of the use of cheap and non-traditional raw materials. Next slide. Ocean water covers more than 3/4 of the Earth's surface, making up 97% of the hydrosphere. The world's oceans, being the sum total of all the Earth's seas and oceans, have a great influence on the planet's activity. The great mass of ocean water forms the climate of the planet, serves as a source of atmospheric precipitation. More than half of the acidity comes from it, and it also regulates the content of carbonic acid in the atmosphere because it is able to deplete its surplus. High levels of the organic elements can lead to organ blooms. Later, the duplication of biogenic elements takes place, and the death of algae and the decomposition by bacteria leads to acidity deficit in surface. Deflection of algae can also activate the process of acidification at the local level. Next slide. Most of the pollution enters the sea from the land, 40-45%. A great danger for marine ecosystem is not only the arrival of chemical pollution, but also the flow of a large number of biogenic regenerated with river runoff, which leads to the eutrophication of sea water. As a result of affluence, the water hypoxic or even dead zones appear. Such affluence can intensify the problems of eutrophication of both areas for which it is characteristic. Next slide. The chemical composition of the algae, organic and microelements, is the main factor for the choice of this algae is the high amount of cellulose through which the paper is produced. Also, an equality important factor is the affordability and the cheapness of the raw material. Next slide. As it is thrown off the shores of the Black Sea in water, it is accessible. Classification, kingdom green plants, homeland shores, genus Zostera. Next slide. Bright leaves Zostera marina used for stuffing mattresses and furniture as a packing material, sometimes as a god, insulated BDN for pets, and for making building materials, carried in large quantities on the shore leaves, and grass sheep can be used as a variable good for the kids. Next slide. Technology of production is in the laboratory condition to combine the process of release of the selection hydrogen in water and removing the posterized mass. The hydrogen is dried in a drying roller and the crystalline state and endorages manual treatment. The nourished hydrogen substance and put into a hydrogen peroxide diluted for the purpose of elimination. The cherried field algae are soaked in water and treated with a blender to a homogeneous state. You can see this on the slide. Next slide. A special frame with a thin grid was used to obtain patterns of paper. The frame is screwed into the semolina section and the set line with the semolina mass is written with the use of primed mesh. All the work was carried out in the laboratory of Shisandu, so this work is available for repetition. Next slide. Received samples of paper products at the moment not very much meets the requirement for most paper production. For indicators of weight, quantity, and so on. But we should pay attention to the fact that in the course of the experiment, I did not introduce additives into the composing of samples. I did not introduce which increasing with weight, roundness, strength, and volumes of the paper. Next slide. Conclusions. I studied the peculiarities of the algae Zostera marina investigated the use of non-timber alternative raw materials in the pulp and paper industry, developed the technology for obtaining the paper, made an experimental sample of the paper, has investigated the properties of the fabricated paper. According to the result of this work, the possibility of using Malgasia stearomarina as an alternative raw material of the cellulose paper industry was substantiated. The analysis of obtained samples of papyrus indicated the prospects of development of this area in order to reduce the extraction of forest resources for the production of papyrus.
Okay, thank you. Daria, so question. I have two questions from Tatiana Sidnichenko. The first one is, what methods of collecting algae can you suggest?
Well, I didn't can you repeat, please?
What methods of collecting algae can you suggest?
What sort
of what way
do you take out plants from the surface water?
But my plants, I want to reduce this paper in bigger
Another question. We ask you, but what way, how do you take out the algae, your plants, from the surface of water, of ocean or river or something else? Do you understand?
Not much.
Okay, how you can collect this algae from the sea, for example?
I may collect this algae. I can order it in internet, or I can myself to take this algae from shores.
Okay. Can this algae harvesting affect the ecosystem of the sea? And in what way?
This algae makes this zone, and it's very bad for seas and oceans because fish are dying and oxygen is not much in the water.
Okay, thank you. Any other questions? Okay.
I have a question.
Okay.
Yeah.
You change, as I understand, you change some slides and some information after yesterday's proposal from me and my colleague.
Yes, I changed my slide, and it is about
and puts some information about pollution.
About pollution of algae in the seas, yeah.
But in my opinion, some slide you need to delete because a lot of information about quality and contaminated inside of algal, it's not useful and for your presentation is my mind.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I will go.
Are you agree with my point?
Yes, I agree.
And only small information you can put about forestry and safety forestry in our planet. What do you think? Do you want to change your mention about your researchers again and prepare more clear information for the first part of your presentation about pollution of water plant and water algal? And second part of your presentation can be show us concretely methods to prepare a paper and add some exclusive of this paper for using, as my colleague proposed yesterday.
Yeah, I changed my mind about it because the Serra Marina is polluted, the shores of the sea, and yeah, and the oceans too. It's polluted. And you said and then
about using your paper. Mm-hmm. Exclusive paper for example for gifts, for example for medicine, maybe for example for exclusive using.
I think it's a good idea because my paper is ecological and it makes
and expensive too.
No, it's not expensive because 10 kilograms of this okay, 50 grams. It's so small.
Not so expensive, but expensive to collect and cut this plant. Okay.
Sorry, excuse me, please. But Daria informed us that this algae used in another industries for furniture, for something else. If it's really so, there is the method of collecting of these plants for industrial purposes. Maybe it's really not the question to Daria. It would be right answer with use of today functional technologies. There are the technologies for gathering. Okay, we will use these technologies and we will obtain our algals. Yes, Daria.
Yes. Well, this algae is used for stacking mattresses and furniture. Yes, that's right.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Okay. Thank you, Dara. It was a big discussion like yesterday, and I guess you need to include all suggestions to your future work. So, Nikonenko Denis, are you ready? Last but
yes.
Not least. So, please start.
Okay. Hello, I am Denis. My work is a complex ecological assessment of water quality of different sources for water supply for Fasti district Kyiv region. Next. On this slide, you can see a quality of work, and I want to emphasize that in the of monitoring the state of water resources, was no information about Fasti community. And the problem of quality drinking water has become especially acute on this region. Next slide. Purpose and the object of the work you can see on this slide. I decided this work because I live in a small village in Fasti district, and I want interested in the state of water use by the population in village and the festive city. It's so important because quality of water is one of the most critical problem in this region. Next. On the slide, you can see novelty of work. For the first time, a comprehensive assessment of water quality of these study sources by hydrochemical parameters, biotesting, and comparable to each other. Next. On this slide, you can see some planning location. First, it's my well. Second, it's a source in Fastiv. This place is very popular. Second, it's River Kirsha. Number four, it's a river in Veprek Forest. Number five, it's source of a central water, centralized water supply in Fastiv. And number six is the most popular well in the village. Next. First, I spent a hydrochemical test of Gaides Kravchenko Olga Alexandrovna in National University of Life and Environment Sciences of Ukraine. Novelty is the hardest of water, calcium, magnesium content, permanganate oxidation. Next. Then I set concentration of trace metal. In the slide, you can see this indicator don't execute as a standard, but to accept of amount of cadmium. Next. On the next slide, we can see index of water pollution and water distribute by purity classes. Next. But I don't stop on this moment and also did some resources of biotesting because this test give more information about water and I can see the effect of water on the organism. This test I conduct in University of Colloid Chemistry and Water Chemistry in Kyiv. Next. Also, I calculate index of total toxicate. On this slide, next, please. On this slide, we can see blood counts and their changes in water number one. Next. With your permission, I don't stop on this slide, but I should talk about water number six. This water have a good
quality.
Have good hydrochemical and biotesting result. And I would like to recommend that this water to use. Next. Is there a result of the study were published in local media? I spoke personally with management of Fastiv management. So I was decided to carry a work to improve water conditional. And this work published it a lot of Ukrainian competition. For example, yesterday my work was published in Now. That's all.
Thank you, Denis. And now we wait for questions.
Can I start?
Yes.
Denis, tell me please, what did you do in this work by yourself? Not without...
Yes, I do a hydrochemical test in Nubib. I do a bio test too.
By yourself, by your hands? And
Yes, yes.
Mm-hmm. And second question is, maybe it's a little bit difficult for you, but what is the main idea of these biological tests? Why these pictures of this microorganism can tell us something about the toxic properties of the water.
Repeat, please.
I try to find another words. You told about toxic properties of the water on the basis of this special medical toxicology tests, yes? Biological tests.
Yes, biological, yes.
Why, what your opinion? What is the reason why we can connect this information with toxic properties of the water?
I think information about toxic water is very important information.
If you don't know, it will be okay. It's not so easy question. But maybe you have some ideas about this.
For example, when you do hydrochemical test, you don't know effect on organisms is water.
No, you are not right. When we prepared these big tables with normatives,
yes,
everything was very many years investigated before, and the name of this element and the concentration of this element were checked many times. And a lot of scientists did this work during a long period. And this new method of biology, yes, method, okay, you told us that... okay.
I know situation when water have good hydrochemical result, but biotesting... have bad result.
Okay, why they had? Maybe this water had not enough concentration of oxygen, for example, or something else. Maybe temperature. Maybe something else. Because I also know, yes, some information about this method, and I'm not sure that. I never listen a real logical discussion and opinion why we can believe to this day, and is really this water is toxic. Okay, if you know something, you can tell. If you don't know, okay, I will be absolutely satisfied.
I think biotest can to replace a lot of enough tests. We can do biotest, and it's so easy and reach.
Easy, yes, but it's not not so clear, and it's not so okay. Yes, thank you very much.
And when you talk people about biotest and about organism diet in this water, people think it's true and don't
can,
use this water.
Can believe to any tales, believe me, please. So this is my
okay.
So next question.
Can I ask?
Yes.
So Denis, you are the one of the leader of our Brain Ring, and you have made a serious work. That is why we ask you a serious questions. I'm interested in your view, not only on looking and finding the different wells with drinking, good drinking water. But I'm interested in your view on artificial systems, which helps us to make from the don't drinking water,
the water of a high quality, because you, for example, have find the place with the better water in your district, but what will be with this place after, for example, some months or years, maybe it became bad as others. So the people in your region, we are living in 21st century, and there are a lot of different methods for water treatment and making a good water for the bad water. What do you think about that? Is it better to looking at different wells with a drinking water, or it may be compared with the methods of artificial preparing the good water for drinking?
I think the best water for drinking is sample number 6. I talked about this because this water have good hydrochemical and biotest result. I think
you have said some words in your work about methods to correct the physical chemical components from the water, like softening, for example, and differentiation. I'm interested in your view on this technology. Can you, like a specialist, recommend to your population in FAST district to use new technologies for water purification, not only to looking a good water, underground water? Because today, underground water will be empty. What to do in FAST district?
Yes, I think it's very important. And I think the most importantly in my work, it's I spoke with management of FAST, and these people can
are they interested in
can to improve this system? Water in my district.
Okay. Can I ask one more question, very short?
Okay.
Denis, tell me please, what kind of water do you use your family at home? What water?
Sample number 1, it's my water in my house.
What is the sample number 1? It's
yes. And,
yes, I don't remember what is the.
Maybe better.
Well,
it's the most.
Where is it?
Better water in my work.
Well, we just silly fabric. Without any purification. We take this water from sewers and
today I know about this water, and I don't use this water because
you take water by some special vessel from this sewers, take it to home and use it for washing, for the dining, for drinking. I'm not sure. In reality, I think you have the source of underground water with the special equipment for water treatment and so on and so on. I believe
that. Yes. So, yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Okay, and the last question from Andrusishna Irina, please slide 11. The question about that your work uses a whole blood biotesting approach, and can it be used to assess the safety of drinking water for humans or extrapolate the data obtained to the effects of such water on humans?
Wait, please repeat, because...
Yulia, a little bit slow. Because even me don't understand.
Okay. Can this biotesting approach, can it be used to assess the safety of drinking water for humans or extrapolate the data obtained to the effects of such water on humans?
Not understandable.
Yes.
Try by other language.
Добре, перейдемо на українську, бо питання дійсно складне. І цікаво дізнатися відповідь, можливо, англійською відповідь. У вашій роботі застосовано підхід біотестування за допомогою цільної крові. Чи можна його застосувати для оцінки безпечності питної води для людини?
Питання...
Так.
First, I don't work with blood because I am 17. I can't work with blood. It's first. Second, yes, because I can see effect this water on blood. On this picture, we can see cell changes blood, and this water so bad for organism because 100% or 100 organism in water die for first 30 minutes in biotest.
Okay, Denis, thank you very much. Тепер, шановне журі, залишається онлайн. Всіх учасників проводимо за очікування і о 1-й годині зустрічаємося на оголошення результатів. Всім дякую. Шановні учасники, шановні керівники, члени журі, наші гості, партнери, спонсори, вітаю вас ще раз. У нас сьогодні така урочиста подія після двох складних, плідних днів праці і оцінювання наших фіналістів. Ми нарешті визначили переможця, який буде представляти Україну на міжнародному фіналі в Стокгольмі онлайн, і визначили інших призерів. Тому пропоную перейти до урочистої частини і для оголошення результатів я надаю слово голові журі Міщенко Тетяні Євгеніївні, президенту Ватернет, доктору технічних наук, професору кафедри технології неорганічних речовин водоочищення та загальної хімічної технології КПІ імені Ігоря Сікорського. Прошу, Тетяна Євгеніївна.
Дякую дуже за запрошення, але мені потрібно...
Зараз так, ми виводимо.
Ну, я поки що почну з вступної частини. Як нам було неймовірно важко вибрати найкращого. Ми дуже навіть не сперечалися, перебирали кожного, і кожен був загалом-то достойний цього першого місця. Але воно одне, на жаль. Тому... Зараз, якщо Юля. Тому ми присудили перше місце Дар'ї Рафеєві, учениці 11 класу Бориспільської гімназії «Перспектива», науковий керівник Лідія Михайлівна Нагаєва. Ми поздравляємо Дар'ю з цією дуже важливою і заслуженою нагородою. І сподіваємося, що вона буде достойно представляти Україну на міжнародному конкурсі, хоч і онлайн, але все ж таки. Поздравляємо, Дар'я, тебе дуже, дуже хороша і цікава робота. Ти її чудово представляла і українською, і англійською мовами. І ми сподіваємося на твої успіхи в подальшому. І будемо дуже раді привітати, якщо тобі знадобиться наша допомога при підготовці презентації для шведського конкурсу, то ми готові через Юлію Бережну, звернись до неї, і ми тобі допоможемо підготувати як найкраще презентацію для Швеції.
Дякую.
Так, наступний, хто у нас? Друге місце. Ну, саме тому, що дійсно всі учасники суперфіналу були майже на одному рівні, ми зробили подвійне друге місце і подвійне третє місце. Оце подвійне друге місце розділили Софія Кулішова з проєктом «Композиційний адсорбент на основі кальцію-альгінату для очищення стічних вод», учениця 11 класу комунального закладу освіти фінансово-економічний ліцей наукового спрямування при університеті митної справи та фінансів з Дніпра, так, Софія? Або хтось може мені підказати?
Так, з Дніпра.
Да? І другим переможцем, срібним переможцем виявився Денис Никоненко, учень 11 класу комунального закладу Фастівський ліцей-інтернат, науковий керівник Наумова Юлія Миколаївна, вчитель хімії, з дуже цікавим проєктом «Комплексна екологічна оцінка якості води різних джерел водопостачання Фастівського району Київської області». Робота дуже перспективна, і якщо Денис буде продовжувати займатися цим напрямком, то ми сподіваємося, що він досягне суттєвих висот, суттєвих результатів і зможе пояснити всій світовій спільноті переваги біологічного методу оцінки якості води перед фізико-хімічним. І нарешті третє місце. На третьому місці, третє місце розділили Володимир Думайло, учень 10 класу Дрогобицького ліцею, науковий керівник, якого ми дуже і дуже поважаємо, багато років знаємо, Віктор Петрович Колдун, завідувач науково-дослідної лабораторії ресурсно-методичного центру науково-дослідних дослідницьких технологій навчально-виховного комплексу Школи комп'ютерних технологій Львівський технологічний ліцей. Це, я можу сказати, прямо кузня кадрів для нашого конкурсу. І Віктор Петрович, наш, можна сказати, лідер з точки зору кількості і якості учасників нашого конкурсу. І розподілили це третє місце з Володимиром. Лобунець Дар'я, учениця 9 класу Шосткінської спеціалізованої школи 1-3 ступеня, номер 1, науковий керівник Павленко Оксана В'ячеславівна. Проєкт «Дослідження можливості використання водорості з остермаріна у якості альтернативної сировини целюлозно-паперової промисловості». Це робота, яка викликала найбільш завзяті дискусії, і з одного боку дуже сподобалась членам журі, але з іншого боку викликала сумніви щодо своєї відповідності тематиці конкурсу. І хоча Дар'я з вчорашнього дня трохи поліпшила справу і покращила розуміння того, що робота є дійсно екологічною і пов'язаною з очисткою води. Але цього не дуже досить. І крім того, треба підтягнути англійську мову. Я хочу відзначити, що цього року практично всі учасники суперфіналу дуже приємно вразили нас рівнем англійської мови. Тобто, якщо раніше, як правило, деякі може бути дуже хороші роботи, ми вимушені були не пропускати на перше місце, тому що пошукувач недостатньо володів англійською мовою, то в цьому році цей признак взагалі був відсутній. Всі діти, можливо, крім Дарії, чудово володіють англійською мовою. Це неймовірно приємно і, можна сказати, відчиняє прекрасні перспективи як для української молоді, української науки і так далі, так і для нашого конкурсу. Тому я всіх вас поздравляю. Мені дуже приємно було приймати участь в якості голови журі в цьому конкурсі, познайомитись з вами і з вашими роботами. І хочу вам побажати як найбільших успіхів, а тим учасникам, які ще не в 11 класі, а молодші, ви можете з урахуванням тих зауважень, які були зроблені в цьому році, це в першу чергу стосується автора роботи з бумагою з водоростей. Ми відкриті до співпраці і готові підтримати вас. І, можливо, наші поради і ваша старанність і відповідальність дозволять вам в наступному році знову прийняти участь у нашому конкурсі і зайняти це прекрасне перше місце. Дякую вам всім і сподіваюся на нові зустрічі.
Так. Дякуємо, Тетяна Євгенівна. Також зі свого боку вітаю вже всіх відомих і перше місце, і друге, і третє. І хочу наголосити, що перше місце у нас отримує таку крапельку, відзнаку. Відзнаку того, що це гран-при, відзнаку того, що далі буде Єрофеєва представляти Україну на онлайн-фіналі. І, окрім цього, всі суперфіналісти отримують цінні подарунки і призи від нашого головного спонсора Україно-австрійської компанії «Екособ БВТ». Про це буде трошки згодом. А поки ще я надаю слово для вітання представнику нашого головного партнера в цьому конкурсі, який вже понад, наскільки я пам'ятаю, 15 років вже з нами. Це надаю слово Косогіну Олексію Володимировичу, заступнику декана хіміко-технологічного факультету з навчально-виховної роботи, кандидату технічних наук, доценту кафедри технології електрохімічних виробництв КПІ імені Ігоря Сікорського. Будь ласка, Олексій Володимирович.
Доброго дня, шановні учасники, шановні організатори, шановні члени журі. Хотів би привітати всіх із завершенням нашого національного етапу всеукраїнського юнацького конкурсу «Водний приз». Завжди дуже радісно бачити, що молодь прагне вирішувати важливі наукові проблеми, важливі екологічні проблеми. Це дуже добре, тому що, як було сказано, ми як...
Юлечка, а що ми про Оксану, Денис? Слышно, да?
Тетяна Євгенівна, перепрошую. Наш університет завжди намагається залучати молодь до таких от наукових досліджень. Дуже сумно, що і цього року, і минулого ми не змогли прийняти вас в наших стінах, тому що завжди побачити вас в живому спілкуванні – це завжди краще і для самої роботи, і для вас. Ви бачите свою роботу з різних боків. Але, на жаль, маємо прилаштовуватись до таких реалій. Тим не менш, головне, що ця робота, незалежно від того, який результат, вона дуже важлива. Ніколи не полишайте спроби провести наукові дослідження, навіть якщо ви не виграли. Це ще нічого не означає. Це лише фактор того, що, можливо, ваша робота дійсно просто трохи не для цього конкурсу, але для іншого. Це не означає, що вона погана чи, може, недороблена. Можливо, треба трохи над нею попрацювати, і ви зможете з нею вийти на національний рівень. Але це завжди добре, тому що молодь може побачити різні екологічні наукові проблеми з тих боків, на які можуть не звернути увагу такі вже, скажімо так, науковці, які багато років мають свою певну думку. Їм складно на це зорієнтуватися. А ви, як представники нової генерації, можете вказати на принципові аспекти і коли можна, як краще це зробити. Тому вітаю всіх і переможців, і учасників з тим, що ви завершили такий важливий етап вашої наукової роботи. Будемо сподіватися, що ми з вами в подальшому побачимось ще і вживу, чи нехай навіть на дистанційну, нехай на конференціях, але прагніть, намагайтеся вирішити наукові проблеми і нехай вам щастить ваших наукових здобутках.
Дякуємо, Олексій Володимирович, за привітання, за такі натхненні слова. І нарешті хочу передати слово представнику нашого головного спонсору, компанії світового лідеру в галузі водопідготовки, компанії, яка підтримує нас, наш конкурс вже понад 10 років. І останні 3 роки, як я вже зазначала, є головним спонсором конкурсу. Це Україна світська компанія, науково-виробнича група «Екософт ВВТ». Запрошую до слова Мудрика Ростислава, директора департаменту розвитку бізнесу. Будь ласка, Ростислав.
Доброго дня всім. Юля, дякую, що дали можливість поспілкуватися і привітати учасників. Ну, я, власне, вітаю учасників Всеукраїнського юнацького водного призу з успішним проведенням цього конкурсу і вашою участю. Ми, як Екософт, вже 10 років не просто підтримуємо конкурс, а підтримуємо його з гордістю, підтримуємо талановиту молодь, підтримуємо керівників. Нам дуже приємно бачити ваш інтерес до водної галузі, ще більш цікаво переглядати ваші роботи, читати, що саме ви досліджуєте. Це викликає такий, знаєте, професійний інтерес і професійну зацікавленість з нашого боку, бо ми в компанії Екософт є з вами точно однодумцями. Нас теж дуже цікавить тема води, адже ми щодня працюємо над тим, щоб забезпечити людей чистою водою. Людей, підприємства, різні галузі. А ще, як ми є частиною великого або найбільшої в світі компанії з очищення води, це компанія БВТ. Ось у БВТ є такий лозунг, він звучить англійською «For you and planet blue». Це означає, що те, що ми робимо щодня в компанії, воно направлено одночасно на покращення життя людей, а також на захист планети. Зокрема, на захист планети від надмірного використання одноразового пластику. І на сьогодні компанія Екософт є лідером в Україні, найбільшим виробництвом фільтрів для води в Україні. Ми об'єднуємо 300 професіоналів, зокрема хіміків, конструкторів, IT-програмістів, інших професій. Ми проводимо в наших R&D-центрах дослідження, створюємо, виготовляємо фільтри. А наші фільтри і системи очищення використовуються в Європі, в Америці, в Австралії, Азії, Африці. Приходьте до нас на екскурсію, побачите, як в нас відбувається дослідження. Вони дуже схожі, і методологія, і дуже схожі дослідження, які ми бачимо вже багато років, зокрема в цьому році, в ваших роботах. У нас на екскурсії ви зможете побачити, як ідеї і дослідження втілюються в життя, бо в нас ось на одному майданчику поєднаний і R&D-центр, і виробництво фільтрів для води. Ну, цікаво, що в цьому році ось суперфіналісти звернули увагу на два аспекти нашого життя – це екологія, і це краще використання природних ресурсів. То було дуже цікаво почитати, які у вас є ідеї про видалення важких металів з води, як зробити озера, ріки кращими, узбережжя морів чистішими, зокрема, виготовляти ще й папір, щоб зберегти ліс. Для нас це означає, що ви не просто робите дослідницьку роботу, як казав ось колега, ви ще й привертаєте увагу суспільства до таких важливих, але непопулярних проблем. Це означає, що в майбутньому саме ви будете робити міста, де ви живете, кращими. Ви будете робити Україну кращою, тому що ви знаєте, ви не просто говорите, ви ще й пропонуєте рішення. І нам особливо приємно, що ви робите це завдяки науковому підходу, завдяки науці. Це взагалі надихає нас на те, щоб працювати ще більше, оскільки ви школярі вже старших класів, але вже робите такий дуже важливий вклад в розвиток науки. І хочу сказати, що незважаючи на ті місця, які сьогодні озвучені, ви всі є переможцями, тому що те, що ви робите, взагалі не популярно, але дуже важливо для вас, для країни. Окрема подяка керівникам, які мають час, сили, натхнення, напевне, терпіння привертати вашу увагу до таких питань. Я зі свого боку хотів би звернути увагу на те, що в ваших роботах вже використовуються інформаційні технології. Там в роботах можна побачити використання мікропроцесорів, засобів автоматизації. Це є надзвичайно важливим. Це означає, що через декілька років ви будете вільно володіти IT і зможете вирішувати такі завдання, які сьогодні не під силу вам і нам. Тому не зупиняйтесь, рухайтесь вперед, ви всі переможці. Наостанок хочу сказати про призи та премії. Юля вже говорила, що всі учасники отримують від компанії EcoSoft BVT подарунки у вигляді фільтрів для води. Крім того, ми підтримуємо призові місця. Ті, хто отримали третє місце, отримують премію у вигляді сертифікату від відомого магазину «Розетка» на 2 тисячі гривень. Друге місце – премія 3 тисячі гривень кожному переможцю. І гран-прі отримує премію у 5 тисяч гривень. Крім того, керівник, який здобув перше місце, теж отримує премію в розмірі 5 тисяч гривень. Дякую вам за участь і бажаю вам успіхів в майбутньому.
Дякую, Ростислав, за чудову оцінку наших дітей, за підтримку, за те, що на наступний рік, я впевнена, обов'язково до нас прийдуть нові учасники і скористаються можливістю обов'язково відвідати виробництво компанії EcoSoft BVT, щоб, власне, переконатися, що це дійсно світовий лідер, і що таке можна робити в нашій країні, і, ну, принаймні, є куди навчатися і працювати. Зі свого боку, також дякую всім. І наостанок хочу надати слово Оксані Денис, головному координатору нашого конкурсу. Оксана дуже натхненно завжди опікується нашим конкурсом, дуже якось так душевно це виходить. І я впевнена, що вона зараз надихне всіх нас на зустріч в наступному році. Сподіваємося, що це вже буде класично в музеї КПІ. Що ми побачимося офлайн, зможемо обійнятися, побачити, поспілкуватися один одного нашого. Оксана, чи можеш ви до нас приєднатися
і сказати? Я на зв'язку, так, я є.
Супер, будь ласка.
Ну, мені важко щось додати ще до того всього, що говорив, про що говорили попередні виступаючі. Я тільки хочу звернути увагу на те, що мета нашого конкурсу, як нашого, так і міжнародного конкурсу, це залучити якнайбільше молоді до вирішення проблем водних ресурсів нашої води. І тому хотіла би закликати всіх учасників конкурсу, всіх керівників, якщо вам сподобався наш конкурс, якщо ви з задоволенням берете участь, заохочуйте ваших друзів, знайомих, родичів також долучатися до так потрібної роботи, до збереження водних ресурсів, до всяких досліджень, розробок, як нам покращити все-таки це наше водне середовище. Тому що, звичайно ж, ми всі хочемо, щоб і наші діти, і внуки, і правнуки були здорові, щоб жили серед чистої природи, дихали чистим повітрям, дивилися на зелені ліси, гаї. І це все в ваших руках. Дуже дякую всім ще раз учасникам в першу чергу за те, що вони беруть участь в нашому конкурсі і приїздять з такими цікавими роботами. Ну і, звичайно, велика подяка всім організаторам, спонсорам. Дякую, Юля.
Дякую всім, колеги. Організаційний момент. По-перше, журі у нас залишається на зв'язку. Всі учасники і керівники отримують інформаційний лист з такими організаціями. Там будуть організаційні моменти прописані з приводу того, як ми будемо надсилати цінні призи і подарунки, відзнаки і дипломи. Тому перевіряйте свою пошту сьогодні до кінця дня, отримайте цей лист. І всіх чекаю наступного року обов'язково, і керівників з новими учасниками, і учасники, які ще мають 1-2 роки до закінчення школи і ще мають таку можливість брати участь в нашому конкурсі. Працюйте, творчого вам натхнення, сили і будьте здорові. До побачення, учасники.
До побачення. Чекаємо вас наступному році.
Бачу вам.